Hello and welcome again to Rigved's Learning. I am Sanjay Sharma, your learning facilitator in the series of videos posted to this channel. In the last video of the A Date with Programming series, you learned about relational and logical operators. It is not only that you make arithmetic calculations or compare data to manipulate and present it. At times, you need to make decisions based on some conditions before you manipulate data in a program. In this video, you will learn about using the conditional operator and solution to the program using arithmetic operators. In a program, when manipulating and presenting data in a comprehensive format, you might have to take decisions based on some condition. Depending on the result of the condition, you decide to select one of the values over the other. Conditional operator is yet another operator which is supported in many programming languages. Various languages have different variations of this operator. We will cover these variations in videos related to these languages. Irrespective of the programming language, the conditional operator requires three operands and therefore is also known as ternary operator. The most commonly used ternary operator uses the question mark colon symbol. The first operand is a condition, while the second and the third operands are some values. When used, it takes the form as variable is equal to condition question mark value 1 colon value 2. In this case, based on the evaluation of the condition, the operator assigns one of the two values separated by the colon symbol. If the condition evaluates to true, value 1 is assigned to the variable, else value 2 is assigned to the variable. For example, Kamna Hill Resort has two types of rooms, premium cottage which is coded as 1 and deluxe room which is coded as 2. Minimum tariff of these rooms is ₹5,000 and ₹4,000 respectively. To check if any discount is given on the premium cottage, you can use the expression check discount is equal to room type equal to 1 and tariff less than 5000 question mark 1 colon 0. Here, if room type is 1, which is premium cottage, as well as tariff is less than 5000, then the value 1 is assigned to the check discount variable, else value 0 is assigned, which means there is no discount given on the room. After checking a condition, if you need to further check another condition, then you can use another conditional operator on the either sides of the colon symbol. As a result, after the first condition is evaluated, the condition in the next operator is evaluated based on the result of the first condition. In this expression, if the condition 1 is true, condition 2 is evaluated. Otherwise, value 3 is assigned to the variable. If needed, you can use another conditional operator in place of the value 3 operand. For example, to find the largest number of the three variables, you can use the expression largest num is equal to first num greater than second num question mark first num greater than second num question mark first num colon third num colon second num greater than third num question mark second num colon third num. Here, you compare the first number with the second number. If it is greater than the second number, then you compare it with the third number. If it is even greater than the third number, then it is the largest number and assigned to the largest number variable. However, if first number is not greater than the second number, then the third number is assigned to the largest number variable because it is greater than the first number, which in turn is already greater than the second number. Now, if the first number is less than the second number, then you compare the second number with the third number. If it is greater than the third number, then the value of the second number variable is assigned to the largest number variable. However, if the second number is smaller than the third number, then the value of the third number variable is assigned to the largest number variable because third number is greater than the second number, which in turn is already greater than the first number. You can also get the same result by modifying the expression as largest num is equal to first num greater than second num and first num greater than third num question mark first num colon second num greater than third num question mark second num colon third num, where you use conditional operator only for the third operand. Using a conditional operator within a conditional operator is known as nesting. Depending on your requirements, you can further use conditional operator at another level. However, you must consider that more you use nesting for the conditional operator, greater are the elements of confusion. In the last video, I had requested you to create a program to display area of a rectangle, perimeter of a rectangle, area of a triangle, and how disproportionate the two sides are after accepting two sides from the user. I hope you have created the program that achieves the result. Here is the solution to the problem statement that you can use to compare your program. Write the program as shown in the scripting area. Program, geometric figure, begin program, integer, side 1, side 2, display, enter the first side in centimeters, exit, side 1, display, enter the second side in centimeters, exit, side 2, display, area of the rectangle is square centimeters, display, side 1 multiplied by side 2, display, perimeter of the rectangle is centimeters, display, side 1 plus side 2 multiplied by 2, display, area of the triangle is square centimeters, display, side 1 multiplied by side 2 divided by 2, display, sides are disproportionate by centimeters, display, side 1 modulus side 2. End program. Let us now summon our virtual memory board and evaluate the program with the dry run. As soon as you run the geometric figure program, the computer reserves a memory block for the program, which is enclosed between the begin program and end program statements. With the integer statement, the program declares and creates two variables, side 1 and side 2 of integer type at random locations within the memory block allocated for the program. We will use these memory chunks to store values of the two sides accepted from the user. Notice that we are using only two variables in the program and displaying the results of the calculations when needed. If you have created a program that uses variables to store results of the calculations, there is no harm. However, as much as possible, we should avoid using variables to store values that can be calculated. As soon as the display statement is run, program writes the enter the first side in centimeters text in the memory, which the display statement takes as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. The memory associated with the display statement is then released for the other statements of the program. When the accept statement is run, it waits for the user to input the number. As soon as the user enters a value, for example 29, the accept statement takes it as an input and stores the value in the side 1 variable existing in the memory block reserved for the program. The memory associated with the accept statement is then released for other statements of the program. With the next display statement, the program writes enter the second side in centimeters text in the memory, which the display statement takes as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. When the accept statement is run, it waits for the user to input the second number. As soon as the user enters a value, for example 9, the accept statement takes it as an input and stores the value in the side 2 variable. With the next display statement, the program writes area of the rectangle is square centimeters text in the memory, which the display statement takes as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. When the next display statement is run, the program multiplies the values of the two sides and the display statement takes the result as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. With the next display statement, the program writes perimeter of the rectangle is centimeters text in the memory, which the display statement takes as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. When the next display statement is run, the program adds the values of the two sides and multiplies it by 2. The display statement takes the result as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. With the next display statement, the program writes area of the triangle is square centimeters text in the memory, which the display statement takes as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. When the next display statement is run, the program multiplies the values of the two sides and divides it by 2. The display statement takes the result as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. With the next display statement, the program writes the sides are disproportionate by centimeters text in the memory, which the display statement takes as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. When the next display statement is run, the program divides the value of side 1 variable by the value of the side 2 variable. The display statement takes the remainder as an input and displays it on the virtual display board. As soon as the end program statement is run, the entire memory associated to the program is released for other activities of the computer. Now let us complete an exercise on using relational, logical and conditional operators. At Kamna Hill Resort, the management wants to check if any discount is offered on the room tariffs. Create a program that irrespective of the room type, premium cottage 1 or deluxe room 2, displays the amount of discount that is offered to the customer. Hint: use the ternary operator to check both types of rooms and the respective tariffs. Try creating this program at your own. I will post the solution for this problem statement at the end of the next video. You can compare your program with the one in that video. In this video, you learned about using the conditional operator and solved the program using arithmetic operators. In the next video, you will learn about using the if construct in pseudocodes. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed creating it, especially for you. If so, do not forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel, Let's Simplify Computers with MrigWatts Learning. Clicking notification, the bell icon will notify you about my new videos.